Alright guys, welcome to the channel. So I just got done painting the wheels. If you haven't seen that video, here it is. But one of the issues that Subaru has is this shit right here, okay? Now as you can see, these are completely destroyed. So what happens is if you tighten down your lugs too tight and you don't do them too torque, this is what happens when you try to take them off. They're on there too tight and then you just literally have to strip them off because it's the only way to do it. So yeah, they seem to be pretty sensitive. I've never in my life had a car where I couldn't decently crank down the lug nuts and not it would never strip. I've done that for a long time in my life of taking wheels on and off of cars to work on them and so forth, and I've never had an issue like I have with Subaru. I've already had this issue before on the other side. I just didn't film it, so I figured why not film it, show you guys how to fix it real quick. So let's get into it. Let's do it. I still have three good ones. I went ahead and bought a ton of them from Rock Auto. So I got these Dorman ones. I got 10 of them. So just in case this happens again for some reason, I'm going to try to avoid that. Make sure that you torque spec your lugs back on. Don't use an impact wrench by any means. Make sure you torque them correctly to avoid this issue. So yep, we're going to pop some new ones in there. And I'm going to show you how to do that.
There's a bolt here, right, at the top. This is for the brake caliper. And you'll see another one at the bottom. There's two. You're going to take those off. And then you'll be able to remove the caliper. So you want to get the caliper out of the way, sit it out of the way, and make sure it's not hanging and hanging on this wire back here. So we'll do that. And then we got to get the rotor off.
So to get the rotor off, you're going to need two M8 by 125 bolts. I have these laying around, but you can buy them. But they're essentially going to go in here. All right, and this is going to help you push off this rotor. We'll set those in there for now. Get ourselves ready, or maybe we'll get lucky and it'll just pop off. All right, so these two back here for the caliper are 17. It's kind of hard to get a socket back there, so a little hammer to help you get it loose because they're gonna be on there pretty tight. Make sure that you're going the right way so you're not hammering tight, because you'll be sitting here hammering forever. So the other side's actually gonna be the other way, so it could be confusing. Just remember, righty tighty, lefty loosey, but you know, it's backwards here. So one. And that's two. And this should come off. Now look at that. You're gonna need those bolts, the whole thing's coming off. Alright, so we don't want that to hang on that wire, so we're going to tuck it up here on the lower control arm. Should be fine right there. And this already came off, so if this wasn't already coming off, basically just screw these in and it'll push it, it'll force it off. These are already ready to go. We'll be able to rotate your wheels. Oh, forgot the other side's painted. Let me go take the tape off the other side. It should be dry, actually.
Yeah, so I painted the other side. Come check this out.
So there they are, fresh silver. Like I said in the wheel video, I can post it right here again on how to do this. It's a nice simple trick and how to easily paint your calipers without even having to take them off. Back to what we're doing. I'm trying to show you this. Basically, see how they kind of push back in here. So how to get these out is you're gonna have to hammer it. So I'll rotate this to our bad one. Earmuffs, because you know that was probably a lot. There we go. She's out. So how do we put the new one in? It's a great question. Slide it in there. So here's one of the good ones. I actually bought new lug nuts as well for when I put the new wheels on, some black ones. But here's one of the good ones, right? So you can't just do this because it's not going to go deep enough. So you could either get a big nut that's going to just slide over this and create space. So when you crank this down, it's going to pull it through. Or you could buy this piece right here, which I recommend. Everything I'm using here will be linked down below in the video description, and those help me out. So this goes right over it. That's a wheel stud installer. That way all you need to do now is take this nut, put this nut on. It's almost went in there, but we'll kick it old school. That's the problem with that. There you go. Off, and I'll try to show you guys what that looks like. As you can see, it's seated on there nice and tight. Flip it over to the other bad one. We'll take care of that one and we'll put everything back together. So of course you just put everything in reverse order. Sucker back on. All right, so once you get these starting to get snug, you just want to snug them up. I don't know what the torque is on this. You can try to torque it if you want, but it's a tight space. Honestly, just put a little elbow into it. It's not going to go anywhere. Yeah, that's good. Well, guys, there you have it. Super simple job, so don't freak out when it happens to you like I did. I freaked out. I've never done stud changes before when it first happened, so I kind of freaked out thinking it was going to be like a major repair. It's not a big deal at all. You can do it. Make sure you just get the right parts. I'll link it down below in the description so you get the correct ones. And that's it. So thanks for watching, guys, and I will see you in the next one. Peace.